2024 marks the 30th anniversary of SeaDAS, a NASA scientific software application with a multitude of tools and science processors, all combined to enable the user to analyze, visualize, and process ocean, land, and atmospheric data. SeaDAS supports over 25 U.S. and international satellite missions, including OCI, HARP-2, and SPEX-1, flying aboard the PACE satellite. In this video, we'll give a brief introduction to SeaDAS and highlight some of its new features. Here, created by SeaDAS, is a true-color, single-day composite image of our planet derived from 14 orbits of data from the VIRS NOAA-20 JPSS-1 satellite sensor. A significant portion of the ocean's radiant signal comes from atmospheric gases, but the SeaDAS science processors can remove these gaseous contributions from the image through a process known as atmospheric correction. By integrating all the VIRS NOAA-20 observations across 2 days, we can potentially remove more clouds, further revealing the enormous size of this seasonal coccolithophore bloom in the Barents Sea. With the hyperspectral PACE OCI satellite data, the SeaDAS Spectrum View tool will take on a new life with enough wavelengths to discern species of phytoplankton. A new tool has been added to animate bands across wavelengths and across view angles, as is the case with polarimeter data such as PACE HARP-2 and PACE SPEX-1. Additionally, for polarimeter data is the new Angular View tool, which creates plots across sensor view angles. PACE OCI files can be quite large due to the quantity of hyperspectral bands, but SeaDAS has tools which allows you to extract data spatially and/or spectrally to improve your system performance. We can use SeaDAS to view and analyze regional scenes such as the Chesapeake Bay. Here we have a level 3 equal area mapped image showing chlorophyll concentration. We can refine this image to show only chlorophyll in the Chesapeake Bay. When we run statistics, we can bound the statistics to this region of interest and get the percent retrievals for this region, along with a full complement of statistical values. We can bring bathymetry data into play and extend our region of interest out to the continental shelf. SeaDAS is designed to directly display the Level 2 and Level 3 files provided from the OBDAC Direct Data Access tool. When loading any of these files, you get the suggested color palette with its range, scaling, and color bar legend. But you can tweak and fine-tune all this to your particular needs. And SeaDAS is easily configurable to use colorblind compliant palettes by default. A key feature of Level 2 data is the presence of quality control flags. These flags indicate whether a pixel might be a cloud, or contaminated with stray light, or sun glint, or there were aerosol algorithm warnings, and more. We can use these flags for the removal of compromised quality pixels. SeaDAS can add file metadata and annotation to an image. When images are opened, layers such as map grid lines, annotation, and a color bar legend can be configured to be automatically displayed. Regarding the SeaDAS science processors, using raw satellite data as input, that is, level 0 or level 1 data, you can generate the same level 2 and level 3 files which are distributed on the OBDAC because you are using the same OCSSW science software that made those files. But you are not limited to the distributed files and products. In creating your own Level 2 files, you have access to a multitude of geophysical products, chlorophyll, sea surface temperature, vegetation index, harmful algae bloom products such as cyanobacteria, to name but a few. You have options for different atmospheric correction models, you can set flagging thresholds, and so much more. In binning from level 2 to level 3, you have more available resolutions, interpolation options, and you can vary which level 2 flags are being applied to more or less aggressively mask out data. In creating level 3 mapped files, you can use any resolution and almost any map projection. And of course, you can define your specific regional boundaries for the image. There is batch processing and, of course, command line operations available as well for the science processors. But even at the command line, the SeaDAS graphic user interface with its organization and tooltips is greatly helpful in determining your parameter setup. SeaDAS offers a growing list of configurable preference parameters to help support its science processors. Regarding the cloud, although SeaDAS does have tools and features which interact with the internet, and SeaDAS processing options in the cloud are in the forecast, SeaDAS does not require an internet connection, and this makes SeaDAS a powerful portable application for a laptop computer. SeaDAS can be used to study any part of our planet visible from space, and SeaDAS can be run from any part of our planet, including from a research vessel in the uttermost parts of the sea. And that's a brief introduction to SeaDAS. To get answers to your SeaDAS, PACE, and OBDAC questions, please visit our forum and websites. The links will be posted in the description below. Thank you for watching, and we'll explore specifically how to use SeaDAS in upcoming instructional videos. So click that notification bell, subscribe, and stay tuned.